Hello, this is Cat's Diamond Painting. Welcome to my channel, or welcome back if you've joined me here before. I am here today to do my post review of the Old Waterway Cottage by Dreamer Designs, art by Dominic Davison. Well, this one has been a long time coming. If you have watched my previous videos, in particular my kind of quarterly review videos that I do every 3 months, you will have seen this painting before. It's featured in Whippin' Chats, it's featured in multiple review videos, and unfortunately, out of all the paintings that I've done, it is one that I've probably had more negative comments about than positive ones. I'm going to preface this post review with the fact that this is my opinion. Okay, so everything that I was not so keen on about this painting, it's things that I know other people really like. So a lot of this is just personal taste. But I just want to go through my thought processes, how I felt about this, that and the other to do with it. So that, you know, if you feel similar to me about these things, then it will give you a bit of a heads up. So what can I say about this painting that hasn't already featured in my previous videos? It has been my biggest challenge as a diamond painter, because I really had to keep pushing myself to keep on at it. I started it back in April of 2022, and it's literally been a case of just doing a row, maybe two rows, but generally just a row at a time, then putting it away for a few weeks till I felt like I could do some more. It's taught me a lot about my tastes in diamond painting. When I bought this painting, I had only discovered diamond painting like maybe 3 months earlier. I think I bought it in July 2021. I wasn't very savvy about looking at a piece of art and knowing the difference of whether I loved the art and whether I would love to diamond paint it. And at the time, I was really into confetti. I wasn't multi-placing. I thought it was great to be changing colours often, because a section of colour blocking that I was going to single place, that, you know, that was far more off-putting to me. As time has gone on and I've got used to multi-placing, so colour blocking doesn't have the same kind of off-putting feel to me, my tastes have changed. So a lot of it is that. But anyway, let's have a look. Let's see, can I get the whole thing in frame? Just about. I'll just tilt you up slightly to show you the top there. Okay, so it's a fairly big painting. It's 80 centimetres by 60 centimetres. That's quite a standard size, I find, for Dreamer Designs, or at least it traditionally has been, and I'll get more onto my thoughts on that later on. The artwork is gorgeous. I love, love, love Dominic Davison's art. And I love that he's being picked up by lots of companies, because I just find his use of light spectacular. I love the nature. It's beautiful. I love it. I love it. Love, love, love the picture. The finished effect of the painting, I think, is lovely if viewed from a proper viewing distance. Where you are in the viewfinder, hopefully it's looking pretty good. Up close, a little blockier, but again, I'll get on to that. But I think if you view this from a distance, it's got the wow factor that I think we all want when we're working on a big project, because you want it to take your breath away at the end, don't you? I loved some of the colour choices. So wherever you've got brighter sections like these flowers, there were some really fun like neon colours. In fact, let me show you. And they were fun to work with, because whenever they'd pop up, it would just be fun. Because as I've said many times before, I'm really, really motivated by colours in a diamond painting. So let me find some of the ones that were nice. So like this one. Can you see it's kind of neon? And I think that was another one too. So they were really fun. And there's some other really nice bright pops of colour in the flowers. And you've got the lovely purple flowers up in the top there. I love all of those. And the glue was good. Even though I've been getting this out I bought it in July 2021, then I've been getting it in and out of the packaging every time I wanted to work on a section since April 2022 until I finished this month, and you know, everything was fine. Actually, I tell a lie, there was a patch in the top left corner, and I was just on my final row and I was desperate to get it finished at this point. No, it wasn't the top right corner, was it? It was the top right corner as I worked on it on my easel. So it was this section here. And I got to it and I peeled the plastic back and it had lots of fluff stuck to it. So this, I am absolutely certain, was nothing to do with the quality of the product and was everything to do with me being clumsy at some point. So I cleaned it off as best as I could with baby wipes and then I used some dot stick. Do you know what? It's a funny story. If you don't know what dot stick is, it's like, well, I'll show you. It looks like this. Diamond Dot sells it. And I'd wanted to get some of this for a while. I'd never actually needed it, but I thought it's a really useful thing to just have in. And a couple of days before I finished this painting, I was on Amazon and I saw it for a decent price because it never seems to be in stock on Diamond Dots. And I didn't want to pay, you know, a load of money to import it or whatever. So it was a bit more than it would have been if I would have bought it from Diamond Dots, but I couldn't do that. And it was a reasonable price to have in. So I ordered it. And then on the very day I got to this section and found that because all that fluff had been on there and all of that, that the glue was just gone, was the day this was due to arrive by Amazon. How lucky is that? So yeah, I used that and that worked brilliantly. And as you can see, that is all absolutely fine in that corner. So there is lots that I love about this painting, particularly looking at it now from having finished it. But let's face it, I wouldn't have started the video in this tone if it was all positive. So I've got a combination of personal feelings like the confetti and just some tweaks that I feel maybe Dreamer Designs could make if they wanted to. Again, though, caveated by the fact that's according to my taste and a lot of people love them exactly how they are. So they're probably doing the right thing, aren't they? Just charting things in a slightly different way to other companies so that there's something for everyone's tastes. I realise I just do not love intense, intense confetti, and that is what I had with this painting. I'll see if I've got a picture of the canvas. I'm pretty sure at some stage I took a picture of the canvas thinking ahead to this moment, and I'll pop that up on the screen if I do have that, just to show you a section. And I don't think it was even one of the like the worst sections for it. There were like 16 colours of green in it, and you'd often just have a section that was just confetti in lots and lots of shades of green. And I'd find that really wearing, or other colours, but just it was slow going. And that's fine if you love confetti, if you're single placing and so on, but sometimes it just didn't feel like it needed such an intense level of confetti. I will say I'm not necessarily good at predicting that. I still sometimes mess up now when I look at a piece of art and I don't really anticipate what's going to be required to bring it to life and then get caught out. And certainly at the time I bought this, that was the case. And there is a lot of detail. You know, you've got all these plants, you've got these trees. Trees always take lots of confetti. You've got loads and loads of flowers. You've got this detailed roof. There's tons in here that had to be confetti. But it did leave me wondering, and I don't know, do Dreamer Designs hand render at all? I'm guessing they run it through a computer program to work up the chart. Do they go over it afterwards by hand and clean that up? Because I just felt like there were some sections that maybe didn't need to be quite as intense as they were. But on the other hand, it could be because of the size, because one of the things that I was going to say was Dreamer Designs do a lot of paintings in 80 by 60. They do some smaller, often like, you know, well, 40 by 60, I think, is another size that features quite often. And they've actually started doing some much longer paintings recently, so maybe they are branching out. And it's not always 60 by 80, sometimes it's 60 by 90. But compared to a lot of companies who will size their painting just according to how they think the art needs to be done, they do often stick to 80 by 60. I reckon if you'd added 10 centimetres all the way around this painting, it probably wouldn't have taken much longer to do because it would have smoothed out some of the confetti in areas where, as it is, it kind of just looks pixelated. I mean, if you look at this up close, and I know diamond paintings aren't supposed to be looked at up close, but bear with me. It just, like, even my husband said, looking at it, he just thought it looked a bit pixelated and blocky in places. And I think if it had been a bit bigger, some of that would have been smoothed out. And it probably wouldn't have made the project take much longer, but it would have been less frustrating. Because I just got so frustrated with how slow going it was. And then stepping back and thinking, but it doesn't even look amazing until I'd step really far back. So I kind of feel like Dreamer Designs do themselves a bit of a disservice. And again, it might be a controversial opinion because I see people all the time asking for standardized sizes on paintings because they like to frame them. And they might really appreciate this. For me, for my taste, I think when they make so many pieces of art fit the 80 by 60 shape, it means that some of those don't come out at their best. And me personally, if I'm investing money into a diamond painting and then I'm investing a lot of time into bringing that diamond painting to life, I want it to look the best it can look. And I prefer that it was bigger or smaller as required in order to do that. I don't know. Maybe that's just me. What do you think? So some other things to mention. The drill quality. It was variable, I would say. So here's my trash pot. Let me shake some of these out into a tray so you can have a closer look. So I would say we had all the standard, that's one of my cat hairs. We had all the standard resin floors that you do find. They all came out to play. So we've got some random bits of resin. We've got ones with holes in. We've got ones with tabs on. And we've got ones that are just generally a bit misshapen. I'm not sure how many you can see in here. There's some that are connected as a twosome. There were quite a few of those in there, like that one. Tabs off on corners, tabs off on sides. Just all the usual suspects, really. And I think, I mean, it's a big painting. I'm fussy, so I pick out a lot of drills. But I'd say that's a fairly hefty trash pot. Like, there's a lot in there. And it did get problematic with some colours because one of the things that I think is always true, in fairness, across all companies that I've worked on diamond paintings from, but maybe seems particularly true for Dreamer Designs. In my limited experience, I've completed 3 paintings from them now and I've noticed this on all of those, is that some colours just are so much less good than others. Like, there were some colours in this that were absolutely fine. You put them in the tray, they'd line up perfectly. They were a dream to work with. And then there were others, like, let's see if I can find it. Oh, yeah. So this one, 469, the quality of this colour was terrible, to be honest. The amount of drills that were uneven and had to be trashed was extreme, and it was hard to actually get them to line up in the tray. Now, this is all I have left. This was a big colour in the painting. There's a big pot that I had, which means if you know how they do these things, they put X percentage of extra drills in to cover you for spares. So if I had a lot of drills in the first place, I would have had more spares than usual as well. And yet this is what I'm down to because there were just that many that I had to get rid of. Let's see. Actually, these last few, they don't look like they're lining up that badly. But when I look at them like really close up, I can see little tabs and things sticking off the bottom of quite a few of them. So that was irritating, and I had that in my last painting for them as well, because there were some colours that would come up and you just genuinely think, oh god, not that one again. It was also a painting that I actually ran out of a colour on. Actually, I would have run out of two. This one, 826, I didn't have enough of when it arrived, but I had seen comments on the Dreamer Designs community Facebook group saying from other people that they'd had that issue. So I knew to look out for that. It just something went wrong in the packaging manufacturing process, and they shorted a lot of people on those drills. So I got those right at the start. I emailed customer service and said, I don't have enough of these. Can you send them? They said, can you complete it and let us know in case you need any others? And I said, look, honestly, being in the UK, you know, it's going to take me a while to work on it. It will take you a while to get me the drills. I know I'm short of that colour. Can you just send them? And they did send them, like, no quibbles whatsoever after that. And I'm glad that I did it that way, given that I worked on the painting for so long. I would have run out of that colour drills months ago. But then there was another one. What was the other one that I ran out of? Oh, it was this one. 799. So again, one of the big ones that you would think I would have had loads of. I know what you're thinking. I actually do have some in there. What happened was I got to the last kind of block of colour in this, saw that I wasn't going to have enough to complete it, found some of that colour in my spare drill stash. But these are from another company, and dye lots do vary. And I don't know how well the camera will pick it out, but they do vary ever so slightly. So I just did that whole section in the spare one, so there wouldn't be like a switch halfway through. So having never ever run out of drills on a painting, I've now run out of drills on a couple of paintings in quick succession. Hopefully that's not the start of a trend. So yeah, a couple of issues with not having enough, but apart from the manufacturing one, I wonder how much of that is to do with the fact that they were just poor quality drills and therefore I was trashing loads of them and then I ran through them really quickly. I do think that they could do with upgrading their drills a bit. I will say I was told that the time when I purchased these was one of the worst periods for drill production, and a lot of companies had problems, you know, going through various COVID lockdowns and that kind of thing. Yeah, I don't know. I need to work on a more recent one, but I have seen it said by other people out there that they've had problems with more recent square drills from Dreamer Designs too. They've done a lot of work to upgrade their kits. So, you know, I've done an unboxing before for Tarot Town and shown you the new canvas, the new toolkit. All of those things are really positive. I do think, based on my, albeit still limited experience, that their drills could do with being upgraded as well. We shall see. Maybe that's in the cards for them. I know that they're good at listening to customer feedback. I see it all the time on their Facebook group. So hopefully that is something that they have in progress. Of course, the problem with the drills that weren't so great was that where I did have colour blocking sections in the sky, which could have been a bit of relief, and I'll show you, just tilt this up so you can see, because there was quite a lot of that. I mean, from a distance, it doesn't look bad at all, but I found them quite gappy and awkward. I was struggling to multi-place with a long multi-placer because they just get so gappy. And that was a bit frustrating, you know, rather than being relief from the confetti, as it sometimes is in landscape paintings. I've said before, and I'll say again, I don't love the old style of Dreamer Designs canvas. I'm so glad that they've upgraded that. It's quite heavy, it's quite stiff. I found it hard to roll the painting around a roller so that I could work on my easel effectively. And it has actually frayed quite a bit in places here. Up there and over here as well. Which is fine for me. This is now going to get rolled up and put in a box, because that's often what I do in my bigger paintings when I'm done with them. But if you wanted to do some of those tricks that we all do, like using acetone to remove the edges or masking tape or something to do a cheap framing job, you know, it's a bit of a pain that it's fraying. It's not the end of the world though. So there it is, the Old Waterway Cottage. As I say, I'm pretty proud that I've got through it, because I didn't want to give up because I wanted to get to the end with this one. I loved the painting so much. But honestly, I had to push myself to work on it at times. And it would take me quite a long time just to do a row. And part of that was the confetti and part of it was I'd do less diamond painting on the days I was working on this painting, because I didn't love it as much. I think maybe I got in my head about it a bit when I found it tough going at the start. And I know lots of other people have absolutely loved this painting. I see their reviews on it. So yeah, it's hard to separate, isn't it? What's a me thing and what's an it thing? And I think it's a combination, with a lot of it being a me thing. But there are genuinely some things I think that they could do with improving on that they haven't already. Obviously, some of the things I've mentioned, like the canvas, they've already addressed. Ultimately, I suppose the big test is, would I do it again? And no, I wouldn't. The other square paintings from Dreamer Designs that I had bought at the same sort of time as I bought this, I have destashed. Because I look at them now, they were bought with a similar mindset, similar eye for detail and liking confetti. And I thought, there's no way I want to do that now. So I've destashed those. I have bought Dreamer Designs again recently. I think I left one in my stash that was a bit of a later purchase. I've bought the tarot, what's it called? The tarot painting that I put up recently, and another round painting, which I still need to do an unboxing for. So I'm not giving up on the company. I think they've got a lot to recommend them. I just think they're maybe a little bit earlier in their evolution towards being, you know, the best quality product that they can be. Because frankly, you know, they're fairly expensive to be dealing with some of those things, like the particularly poor quality drills. I do feel like most companies have kind of ironed that out by now. So there we are. The Old Waterway Cottage is finally done and dusted and going away in my cupboard. And I do still love the finished design. I think it's beautiful. Loads of ABs. I should have mentioned that too. Lots and lots of ABs, which seems typical of Dreamer Designs. I think there were 4 colours. Let me check. Yep. 4 ABs, and I'm not sure how well they've been picked up in this camera angle. I'm gonna pan over it in a moment, actually. But they are sort of peppered everywhere. There's blues in the sky, there's greens peppered in through the trees, there's whites, like we've got a nice swan in white ABs, there's purple ones mixed in with the flowers. So they're really nicely done. I also really like this grass section, by the way. That's got a lot of green ABs, I believe. Let me check. Yeah, they're quite subtle, the Dreamer Designs ABs. You have to kind of get closer to see them. And that really brings out the kind of sunlit bright effect that you get in the original painting. So I like that a lot. This, by the way, is a cat, I believe, from the original painting. Can't really tell. Okay, I'm going to pan over this now and then I'll just come back and say goodbye. Okay, I hope that you've enjoyed this and enjoyed taking a look at this beautiful diamond painting with me, because it is still a beautiful diamond painting. I do really love it now that it's done and I don't have to work on it anymore. As I always like to point out at these times, please don't be put off from trying them yourself. If you look at this and you think, actually, that is my taste, I do like that mega confetti and I don't mind, you know, 16 different shades of green, etc. Because we all like different things and that's absolutely fine. And as I said earlier, I really like that Dreamer Designs does cater to slightly different tastes. And it's probably best that they keep on representing different people's tastes to other companies that I buy from, so that they're not all just doing the same thing. But within that, there are a few things, as I've mentioned, that I think could actually improve the experience all round. So thank you for joining me today. If you have enjoyed this video, please do drop a like on the video. It really helps to get the video out there being seen by more people. And if you're not already a subscriber, I would love it if you would like to subscribe. Thanks for joining me today, and I'll see you next time. Bye.